is Taizan Watari, and he will tell us about polyakov pass integral as modular parameterization with a question mark. Yeah, please start.
All right, thank you very much, Masahito and the Ashwin and Abhiram for organizing this workshop. I'm looking forward to what happens in this workshop. So, what happened? So here is the elevator pitch for me. Let's think of the elliptic curves with the complex multiplications. And then, in string theory, we usually think of them as the complex analytic manifolds, or sometimes also as the algebraic varieties defined of a complex number fields. And in that category, still, they come in a kind of families, and those families are grouped together under the language of the class free theories and ideal class groups. That's fine. And yet, even though string theories tend to see them as manifold over the complex number fields, and yet if you begin to see them as the algebraic varieties defined over number fields, sometimes that's possible, and it is possible indeed in the case of elliptic curves with complex multiplications. And then even for a given complex analytic manifold elliptic curve like this, and yet we begin to see infinitely many models in algebraic variety defined over number fields like this. And in the context of Langlands correspondence, for those elliptic curves and for those elliptic curves, different kinds of the weight to modular forms are assigned in those ways. So here's a large picture, and that's also the observation I wish to tell you about in this presentation. So as a string theorist, it is a very natural question whether the modular forms and also the modular transformation have anything to do with the genus one string theory amplitude. So let's think of the elliptic curves of Shimura type here, and then we'll construct the representation of the Galois group over the field of imaginary quadratic field of complex multiplication. And furthermore, we can think of the induced representation of the Galois group of the field of rational numbers, G sub Q. And in the Langlands correspondence, we have weight to modular forms. And there, the modular forms that I showed in the previous slide correspond to those modular forms in that context. Now, incidentally, in string theory, we may think of the elliptic curves seen at the complex analytic manifolds as target space in string theory. And we add also the Kähler parameters as well. And we may think of the genus one amplitude, and that's a specific class of observables. It's a word defined. And then it is a function of the complex structure parameters of the world sheet, tau world sheet. And then we can see actually that the d tau times this observable combined with appropriate linear combinations can be seen as the well-defined the one form globally on some appropriate modular curves. And they're indeed Heckel-Theta functions. And actually the modular forms there were also Heckel-Theta functions, so they agree. Whether this correspondence, the other way to get the same modular forms, is accidental or not, I do not know. And that's a question I wish to know as well. One possible observation in that context is that the modular forms that you have in the context of the Langlands correspondence and also in the context of theory of modular parameterization are known to be the pullback of holomorphic forms on the target space, pullbacked by the surjective map to those elliptic curves, to the modular curves. And also in the string theory context, this class of string theory observables has the pullback of the holomorphic one form of the target space. So the agreement on both ways, maybe more than accident, I don't know. But anyway, that's the observation I wish to tell you about. So that's the end of the elevator pitch. So